Do you know any couple of words in Kinyarwanda? Umunyamakuru.
Umunyakuru. Umunyakuru.
Umunyamakuru.
Umunyamakuru. Makuru.
What can you say?
Amazi.
Amazi.
Amata.
Amata.
Agatsinsino.
What? Agatsin? How do you feel?
Well, when I first came to Rwanda, I was excited. Oh, I was nervous too, because I was meeting his family, so... But everyone's been really nice. Yeah.
Is everything good?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you.
Are you excited for this interview?
I'm a little bit nervous.
Twongeye kubasuhuzaho kurikira Aisho 250 TV show. Ndagushimiye ko wakoze wahisemo guhitamo ino channel. Kandi ujye ukurikirana ibiganiro byacu bijya bitandukanye. Uyu munsi twifuje kuganira na Michelle. Navuga ni umunyamahanga waje gusura u Rwanda ndetse akaza mu buryo bw'akazi. Tugiye kuganira ku bijyanye n'ubuzima bwe ndetse n'akazi uburyo agakoramo nubwo nuko afata igihugu cyacu. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. I'm a little hot, but I'm good.
You're hot?
Yeah.
Okay. Introduce yourself. Like, who is Michelle?
Well, that's a big question, but my name is Michelle. I originally come from Canada.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm still studying journalism as well. And yeah, I guess that's what I have for now.
Okay.
Funny much, that's nice. So, do you know any couple of words in Kinyarwanda?
What can you say?
Amazi.
Amazi.
Amata.
Amata,
Agatsinsino.
What? Agatsin?
Yeah. Agatsinsino.
Agatsinsino.
And urakoze.
Urakoze.
Urakoze. That's pretty much
like
it.
When you say urakoze, it's one person. And if you want to say like for many people, murakoze. You just have to add mu and you. Like it's mu and then you. So you is one person. Mu is many people. Murakoze.
Murakoze.
Murakoze is like saying, thank you so much, guys.
Like to a crowd.
Yeah, it's a crowd. And then if you say
urakoze, it's one person.
Okay.
So can you say murakoze?
Murakoze.
Wow. You're pretty much good.
How did you become a journalist?
So right now I'm at school, still in Canada, but because of COVID, I'm studying online, so that's why I could be here like for this whole year. But do you want me to say like how I found journalism?
Yeah.
Okay, so originally when I was applying for university, I really wasn't sure what I wanted to do. Because there's a lot of options I wanted to do. I was thinking of social work or nursing or political science. Like all I knew is that I wanted to do something that helped other people, you know, and also change the way things are to make it better. And yeah, I've always been interested in having conversations with people, you know, and also creating. So I liked making videos and writing and things like that. So I kind of just fell on journalism. Wow. I didn't originally think I was going to do it. That's what I decided.
So do you want to work for maybe a company or you want to work for your own self?
Afterwards, when you're done in school.
I'm not sure. Honestly, like, I think the dream is to work for myself, obviously. I want to have my own business, you know, my own... like freelance, but I think to start off I'll have to work for somebody else.
Wow.
Until I can.
That's nice.
Yeah.
That's pretty much nice. So, you know, in English they say a journalist.
Yes.
As you are. You're learning to becoming a professional journalist.
Yeah.
So, have you learned any words like to say I am a journalist in Kinyarwanda?
Not at all.
Do you want to say, do you want me to teach you?
Yeah, sure. How do you say?
Umunyamakuru.
That's a hard one.
Try.
Can we try again?
Umu. Nyamakuru.
Umunyakuru.
What?
Oh my god,
it's so hard. It's cool, it's cool. People will teach you. They can comment down below. I can show you how to write it. The next time you want to speak in it well.
Be one of the five words I know.
Umunyamakuru.
Umunyakuru.
Umunyamakuru.
Umunyakuru.
Umunyamakuru.
Umunyamakuru.
Makuru. Umunyamakuru.
Umunyamakuru.
Yeah, that's how
it's a little rough.
It's a little bit rough, and if it's your first time to experience it, it's kind of hard to repeat it. But I know the more you keep saying it, it will be better and better.
So my partner is from Rwanda.
Your partner?
Yeah.
Oh, you have a partner?
Yeah, Emma. You know him.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about you.
Yeah, well, I don't know. So we met maybe 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago. And then at the beginning of this year, he had to come back. And
convinced you.
Yeah, I was like, I was able to, so I was like, why not just come? I was like, okay, let's go.
So he's your boyfriend?
Yeah, my boyfriend.
Oh, you know, why are you afraid of saying your boyfriend?
I don't know. Yeah, he's for now just my boyfriend, I guess.
You are shy?
Yeah.
You don't have to be shy.
He seems to be a cool guy. Even though I know him, but people who are watching us, they don't know him.
Yeah, he's pretty nice. He's okay, I guess.
Really?
Pretty okay, yeah.
Okay, so except saying amata, amazi, had
there any other words he taught you?
Ndagukunda.
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 This means I love you.
Yeah.
Okay. What else?
Agapakamungwa.
What?
Agapakamungwa.
Agapukamunwa.
Agapukamungwa.
Agapukamunwa.
Agapukamungwa.
What is that?
A mask.
Mask. So you say it in Kinyarwanda name?
Yeah.
You say?
Agafukamunwa.
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 This is so cool. Agafukamunwa.
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 Aga.
Aga. Fu.
Fu.
Ka.
Ka.
Mu.
Mu.
Nua.
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 Yeah. So repeat that.
Agafukamunwa.
Munwa.
Nua.
You keep forgetting nua.
Nua.
Yeah. Yes, and gua. It's okay. You will learn slow by slow.
Yeah.
Okay. That's pretty much, that's all you know, or there's some other words?
I feel like I know more. Oh yeah.
You know, you do.
Chane.
Chane. What does that mean?
Thank you.
Murakoze. Chane.
Chane.
Chane. Is
chane thank you? Chane, it's a lot.
Oh yeah, like thanks a lot, no?
If you say thanks a lot, means thank you. Yeah, thanks a lot. Murakoze.
Chane.
So if you say murakoze, it's thank you. Then chane a lot.
But can you just say it as a slang, like ah chane?
No.
No.
You can say maybe murakoze.
Ah, okay. So Emma taught me wrong then.
Yeah, your partner convinced you to come to Rwanda. So far, how did you find Rwanda? Like for when you stepped here on Rwandan soil, how did you feel?
Say it in Kinyarwanda. People would like to hear that.
Hey, you think I know how to say that in Kinyarwanda?
Yeah, I think you're pretty much smart.
The words I told you is the only words I know.
How do you feel?
Well, when I first came to Rwanda, I was excited. Oh, I was nervous too, because I was meeting his family, so... Mm-hmm. But everyone's been really nice. Yeah.
So how long have you been here?
Since January.
Since January?
Yeah. Oh. So that's like 6-7 months about.
7 months?
In Rwanda?
Yeah.
So which means you have experienced as many places as possible.
Yeah, I mean, we went on a trip with his parents around the country. Mm-hmm. I think we didn't go to the east, but we went north.
Where? Do you remember the names?
I was just there for the ride, you know?
You don't remember any place? Did you go to Nyungwe? Do you know Akagera?
Akagera, do you
that, that rings a bell.
Can you say Akagera?
Akagera.
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 Yeah, that's like the national park.
Oh no, I didn't go there.
Okay. So
we went to Le Kivu.
Le Kivu.
Yeah.
Gisenyi.
Gisenyi.
Ah, okay.
And
nice. Did you have some time to swim from Kivu?
No, because of COVID we can't go swimming. You can't go in the water.
Do you know how to swim?
Of course I know how to swim.
Every Canadian knows how to swim.
It's part of growing up, you have to.
Can you describe yourself?
In short.
I guess I'm shy mostly.
I was going to say that.
I would say that it's weird, you know, because I'm shy, but I like to talk a lot to other people. Mm-hmm. But I'm more of like a, tell me about yourself.
So you're social?
Yeah. I like to talk. Yeah.
That's cool.
So how do you start your day?
So I wake up earlier than I would like to because we have dogs at the house and they're always barking in the morning. Mm-hmm. So we wake up a lot earlier, so I usually wake up and let them out mm-hmm. of the house.
And you go back to sleep?
No, by then I'm awake, you know. And I usually go on my phone, you know, like since it's 6 hours behind, I don't know, ahead in Rwanda, I have text messages to answer because, you know, everyone's awake when I'm sleeping. Mm-hmm. You know, eat breakfast, do that kind of a thing.
Mm-hmm. And then you go to work?
Yeah, usually I go to work or sometimes I work from home too.
Okay, so
I was going to say that, so you guys, do you guys have any plans of being married?
That's not up to me, that's up to when he wants to ask.
Do you?
I don't know. I guess so. I mean, so, if I'm here.
Uh-huh. You want to?
I don't know. I don't
know. Okay, that's a tricky question.
So your boyfriend, is he an African or he's also white?
He's from Rwanda.
He's Rwandan?
Yeah.
Waha.
Like, he was in Canada for 4 years about. So he's not like, he grew up here too.
Okay, pretty much.
Yeah.
So how do you see guys from here in Rwanda and compared to Canadian ones?
I guess a generalization. Boys in Canada are more shy.
Uh-huh. How?
You know, it's all through like dating apps, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, not a lot of people will like. I mean, sometimes there are, but you know, it's like there's less common to go up to someone and be like, "Oh, hi." You know, it's mostly like on the phone, mm-hmm. things like that.
And then Rwandans.
You know, they're more upfront a little bit.
So they like to talk. Which means he's talkative.
Surprisingly, my partner is, you know, more quiet and reserved.
Really?
Low-key, I don't know, low-key. But then when we first met, he was super excited and like, you know, super social, so it's funny now.
So were you excited too?
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah. Why? Then he must be a good guy, because I can see he takes care of you and you're like too happy.
Yeah, we're both happy.
Okay, that's nice.
One of my difficulties, actually, you know, because I put too much on my plate and then I don't have enough time for everything. Uh-huh. But, you know, but at the same time, I feel like, you know, I'm pretty young, you know.
Come on.
So, okay. Yeah, so, you know, it's the time to try new things. So even if I ever get stressed sometimes, well, sometimes you have to do what you have to do to figure out what you like, you know?
Okay, have you had more than 10 boyfriends?
Yes, nope.
Or no?
Nope.
Okay. Between African and Canadian guys, if you are on a date and you were to choose and they're both, you like them, whom would you choose first?
I don't know, man. Man, I don't know. You have to get to know them. That's my final answer.
If Emma was to say, will you marry me? Would you say yes or no?
I mean, yes. I guess.
You guess?
Yes.
You just have to say yes or no.
Yes.